Alright, what's up guys, and we're back with another Legends video, and today we have like the Shadow Dragons. So we have Ice and Nova Shenron here. So just to sum these guys up, Nova Shenron is going to be the main, you know, sort of like main damage dealer here. He's mainly strike oriented. I don't think his green card's going to be very useful, the barrier, kind of similar to Broly's one. Knocks enemy back to long range if they're at close range, and it gives us strike damage and a key by 30, and we can also combo it. So that's just the difference between his barrier and Broly's one, is that we can combo it. It's also kind of similar to the free-to-play Buhan's barrier, because we can combo that as well. And his main ability locks the opponent in for 10 time accounts, and it also destroys our own and enemy's cards as compensation, because obviously it's sort of going to be cheating. So we're definitely going to have to pop that main ability if we have no cards left, because then we won't have any cards to destroy. So this would make sense to do that. So we should really pop this main ability where we have no cards, and then it will just only destroy the enemy's card and then give us the 20% of damage inflicted. I also get one vanish back, so it's the exact same thing as the Zenkai Super Saiyan Blue Goku. You know, the main ability is just gives us a free vanish, so that's going to be useful. And then a card draw speed for 10 time counts. Okay, that's very nice. And then now he gets 70% of damage inflicted. Obviously, he's going to be getting stronger, like the more Dragon Balls that we possess. So it says, per Dragon Ball you possess, we get a 10% of strike damage. So that means we can get a total of 70% strike damage if we have all 7 Dragon Balls. So yeah, that's going to be really useful. And then like these are the time-gated buffs, but it's not even that deep, to be honest. It's not like over 10 counts. So pretty much this is going to be natural, because we're going to be in with this guy longer than 10 counts. So after 3 counts we get 20% damage inflicted, 5 counts, 1 level of arts card draw speed, and 8 counts we get 50 key back. And this is sort of like the unlimited thing, so that every time we switch into him, we can build this up the more counts we stay in for him. So that's Nova Shenron, and then we have Ice Shenron here. So like this guy's geared towards being annoying and also hitting hard at the same time. So he's a ranged type unit, he's more blast oriented. And his blue card, yeah, so this is why, but this is just one impact of him. His blue card is just a bunch of debuffs, seriously. 20% to impact damage, seals enemy card slot, cannot be used for 10 time accounts. Like the green card, it literally, oh my gosh, there's so many debuffs. It literally, like the green card gives us some defense first, and then like here's the most annoying bit. It literally destroys the opponent's like blue card, awakened, or ultimate card. And then yeah, there's so many tag. This is sort of like a similar activation thing to Zenkai Gogeta. So when the opponent does a tap attack, tackle, or strike arts, then this will do a counter. So okay, it's very similar to the Red Gogeta. So I can't wait to see how that works. And then it also immobilizes the enemy, so he can't move. And there's so much going on here. Like the main ability, it literally it gets rid of the opponent vanish, as well as give us a blue card. So it's literally the same as the EX Green Vegeta. He does the exact same thing too. Gets rid of the opponent's vanish and gives you a blue card. Like there's so many damage inflicted here. That was it. A GT sub count, that's gonna be useful. He also gets 70% damage inflicted. Minus costs, honestly. He is anti-Fuma Warrior, because he's literally debuffing them. And when this character is on the battlefield, it seals like the opponent's strike cards when the enemy switches characters. So that's literally the same thing as the Blue Ultimate Gohan. So annoying. So that's going to be good. And then this passive is just full of debuffs, honestly. This is absolutely mental. So since it says when faced with an enemy, when the enemy switches, these buffs will just stack on the opponent. So literally, like the more they switch, like the more debuffs they'll get from this passive. So that's gonna be very annoying. So we try these two guys on a GT style team first, and then I will do these guys on a powerful opponent team, because I feel like these two Shadow Dragons will be more impressive on powerful opponent, I believe. So I mean, we'll see how they do on GT. I mean, like their kit is really good, so like it's not like they're gonna be doing like crap damage at no stars. they're definitely going to be doing solid damage even at, you know, like 2-3 stars because of their kits, you know, like the 70% damage inflicted, that cannot be cancelled, and the so many debuffs, loads of damage inflicted in the kit. So yeah, this could be interesting. So for Nova Shenron, he's strike oriented, so I put this equip on him, and also this special platinum equip that they released when Super Saiyan 4 Goku got his Zenkai. This one gives a 20.5% strike attack, although I could roll it higher, but literally these equips are so hard to get to, like literally close to an S, like they're so hard to just even get close. So this gives health restoration as well, which is quite interesting, and this also gives pure strike attack when blue or green is a battle member, and since we're running Ice and Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta, that's pretty much going to work. So with Ice Shenron, we're going to be running Blast Origin equip, so this one, like this one also gives more pure blast attack when yellow or purple is a battle member, so yellow being the Nova Shenron, so this will work as well. And also this one gives strike attack as well, because he's a ranged type unit, the best of both. And then for Gogeta, obviously strike oriented equips. So yeah, that's enough waffling, and let's jump into PvP and see how these two new Shadow Dragons do in PvP. Okay then, here we go, first match of the video, and we're going up against a powerful opponent team, so clearly we know who he's going to bring, Broly, Jiren and Rosé. So okay, this actually looks pretty decent to start with. So I guess let's start with Ice Shenron, because let's just be the most annoying one at first, because when we start with him, all the strike cards on the opponent will be locked. So yeah, let's do this. Okay, here we go. So Broly's definitely going to be a painful one, so hopefully we don't have to deal with anything like that. So let me just do the blue card, let's just debuff Jiren while we're at it. Oh crap, I totally forgot that this was a barrier, but okay, we got him anyway, so we're good. Let me drop combo. Yeah, there we go, there's Broly. Let's go to Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta then. Yeah, amazing damage to Broly as usual. Obviously we'll go to Goku Black. We're very short on key, so we have to be careful. Oh, well done, okay. Well done. He actually got me there, okay, interesting. Let's go to Ice Shenron, okay. Because when he switches, there we go, so his strike cards are all locked. I can see that he waited there, so yep. Got him there, there we go. That was perfect use of Ice Shenron, amazing. So yeah, not bad damage, honestly. They could be better, but so yeah, like we'll pop the main ability, we'll lock him in. Let's try and get the barrier. I'm trying to get the barrier, so let me see. Does this work? Yes, it does. Okay, so that's nice. Ah, crap. I really don't know he would do that. So let's keep priority by switching into Gogeta and using one of his cover changes. Okay, very nice. There we go, there's a sidestep. Okay, so Rosé. Oh, Rising Rush then with Ice Shenron. And we'll go for Blast because Rosé is strike oriented. Of course he'll guess us. So, my days. Okay, fair enough. Let me go to Nova Shenron. I feel like he can Rising Rush does, so this not good. Yeah, he's gonna Rising Rush does. Okay, fair enough. Let me go for a strike card. Let's see. Yeah, there we go. Like you guess me, I guess you. I guess that's fair enough, so. Okay, fair enough. Yeah, there's nothing I could do there. I literally have to sack him off. Okay, so let's pop the main ability. So now he has no vanish, so he can't do anything. Yep, there we go. Perfect. Okay, so let's go to Gogeta and go type neutral. We'll cancel buffs. Okay, so that's exactly why I want to get Rosé out of the way. And then since we have a blue card, we can do double blue cards, because when we pop one, we get another one. Hopefully this kills Rosé. I want Rosé out of the way. Good, okay, there we go, nice. Oh damn, I did not know you would go full force, Jesus Christ. Okay, I think that's a... yeah, okay, so that's a green card, so that's good, that's fine. I don't mind myself being locked in. Oh, he's trying to go for Blast Armor, isn't he? Yeah. Okay, so we nullify coverage. Wait, what? Oh man, like, it's run out, hasn't it? Yeah, it's run out. That's why. Okay, that's fine. The cover change nullification has run out, I think so. Okay, that's fine. There we go. Okay, so let's go to Ice Shenron. I know you're thinking, why the hell, you know. It's fine. There we go, so Jiren's hopefully dead with this. Ah, no, he barely remained alive. Crap. Let me try. Ah, no. Alright, that was good. But he has no vanish now, so unlucky, mate. Wow, yeah, she switched. Interesting, okay. Damn. Very good play, to be honest. Let me try and land the green card, because I have no idea what it does. Well, it was too late anyway, so... Okay, whatever. Let me just go for a strike, a blast card. Let's just keep tapping him down. Let's do this. Yep, there we go. Like, even blast double couldn't save him, so... Yeah, so, I mean, like, so far, Ice Shenron was really impressive, honestly. Like, him getting rid of Vanishing Gauge and stuff like that, we can really take advantage of that. Like, they just get, you know, like, I mean, it just takes a bit of time to build them up, but so far, they're not bad. So, alright, moving on. Okay then, next match of the video, and we're going up against a good-looking future team there. So, Gohan, Zamasu, like, the Trunks one, Goku Black, definitely going to be very annoying, but it's not looking that bad, so... I think we'll start Ice Shenron once again. You know, like, we'll just lock the player's cards and yeah, just be annoying. So, alright, let's go. Okay, so surprisingly, he didn't bring Green Goku Black, but okay, it's fine. Let's just, okay, that's fine. Yep, I'll take that damage, it's fine. Okay, this guy's good. Okay, please go for a blast card. There we go. Oh, I nearly got him, but he sidestepped, so... Fair enough. Okay, I've really screwed up there, but okay, it's fine. Oh man. I was basically trying to armor cancel him, if you know what I mean, so... Because like, it was literally blast armor from long range, so it would just be stupid if I just, you know... There we go. So there's Blue Goku. Let me go to Ice Shenron then. Get rid of Vanish, and we'll just... A pop one, you know? Yep. Well, we'll just be really annoying, honestly. Okay, so since we have one card, we'll get this ready. Damn, he switched really late. Really quick, I meant. okay, yeah, this is where the lock-in could be used against me, actually, because, It's literally about when you time it right, I think, so... Okay, so luckily he ran out of cards, but flip's it. TVs, yeah! great. Okay, that was really obvious, so... And Gogeta nullifies endurance, so hopefully we can get this in. Yeah, okay, so this Gohan's probably dead. Oh no, it was so close. It was so close. That could have killed him. God's sake. Okay, it's fine. It's really hard that he locked our cards in, so... Okay, we'll go back to Ice Shenron then. There we go. So we landed that one in. Nice. So he's now immobile. And we can Rising Rush him. There you switched ability to blue. Perfect. Exactly what I wanted to. This is all working out well, yeah. Man, Ice Shenron is really impressing me so far. Like, much better than Nova Shenron, actually. Ice Shenron is definitely impressive. At just 2 stars. That is absolutely amazing. So, okay, he keeps tackling. Let me go for... Yep, there we go. And GG. That was good. Yeah. This guy is very impressive with his debuffs and vanishing gate. Oh my. Like, I like this unit already. Yeah, very nice. Okay then, next match of the video, and we're going up against someone who probably going to do mono purple or a purple blue, which is quite interesting, but okay, this is not good actually, because Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta, but okay, let's hope no other Shenron can actually do something this time, so we'll start off Ice Shenron once again, be very annoying, and yeah, let's go. Okay then, this will be very annoying because he literally has everyone above 10 stars, so okay, we got a nice start there. I know he's going to switch to Trunks. Yep, okay, that's fine. I'm staying in for now. We'll do this. Okay. So looks like he's just the type to go straight away, which is good on iron, but... Let's get rid of his vanish, yeah, alright. He can't do anything now. There we go. Perfect. Oh, interesting. Interesting there. Let me try and... There we go. So we just went straight away. Full force. I bet you didn't expect that. Strike oriented. I keep forgetting that he's strike oriented. So, yeah, there we go. I'm always comfortable with using blast cards sometimes, so that's why he's just... Okay, we'll save that one card. It's fine that our Dragon Balls are gone, but to be honest, yeah. Let's just do this. Okay, so we landed that first, didn't we, so... Okay, Ice Shenron then. Okay, so I'll go to Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta, and then we'll do a type neutral ultimate, and that'll get him out of the way, so he's dead. Yeah, like honestly, Super Saiyan 4 Gogeta's type neutrality is just way too OP. We've literally managed to take care of a purple unit like that. So yeah, that's good. Okay, we'll stay in. We'll get a bit of more ki if we can. Damn, he got me there. So we'll go to Ice Shenron. Damn, he nearly died there. But yeah. Okay, you have no vanish there. Nice, that was good. Let's see if we can land this. Yes, we did, hey! The green card counter. Oh my god, immobile and beaten. Jesus Christ. But Ice Shenron is really seeing the show. I feel like, yeah, he's the most impressive out of the Shadow Dragons, honestly. Very good unit. We'll go for one more. Okay then, so we'll make this the final match of the video. We're going up against a Fusion Warrior team. Okay, so this could be very challenging. The Zenkai is right there, so... Zenkai, oh god, This could be very challenging for sure, but we'll see what we can do. We'll start Ice Shenron and yeah, let's go. Okay then, so quite interestingly, he didn't bring any of the Zenkais, which is good on our part, but... It's going to be quite a challenge still, so... Okay. They've got a switch for me. Okay, he won't switch, which is quite interesting, but... Yeah, he's not going to switch because he probably knows that. Okay, there we go. So, let's go to Gogeta. There we go, we got him there. Nice. Okay, so he's used up one of his cover changes, which is good. We still have R2, so... Okay, so he loves the weight as well. Okay. I'll keep that into consideration. Oh, you know what? Let's just lock him in and get the card draw speed while we can. So, come on, there we go. So we got that that in. Okay. No, it's not at long range. No, it's not at short range, is it? Otherwise, yeah. Okay. I need to practice using this barrier more because it's not supposed to be at long range, otherwise it's pretty much a drop combo, so okay. Fair enough, okay. Drop combo. Oh my gosh, that was a mental weight, okay. Green card maybe? No, it was a strike card. Okay, yeah, that was... I should have waited, but... That was bad play on my part. Okay. I need to see Rising Rush Ice or not. Okay, so he overextended there. You know what, I'm just going to go for the ultimate straight away. Yeah. Yep, I knew it. That did okay damage, actually, yeah. Damn, he went straight, full force. Jeez, okay, okay, nice. Let's see if we can land the second one. There we go. Ah, fam, it nearly killed him. Oh my days. Okay, we got that PV, so that's nice. So no type disadvantage anymore, so... Match up his lost card. Damn, oh my gosh, he waits too long. He waits too long, but I don't know how he does it, seriously. I even tried to match my blast with him and make him cover change, but it's just not okay, okay, whatever, it's fine. There we go, nice. If I could just Rising Rush go these to blue, then it's all good. Nah, it failed. Yeah, it failed. I don't think this is an LF. I don't think so, no. If it is, then fair play. Yeah, it is. Oh, man, really? that was close. That was close, though. That was close. I think if I Rising Rush just a few milliseconds earlier, then he wouldn't be able to cancel out of it because that was a tackle, but oh well, that was actually a good match though, so yeah, GG. Alright then, so far, my initial thoughts on the Shadow Dragons, Aishen was the better one, like so far, he's pretty much the better one. Although Nova can do damage, it's just, you know, the Aishen was just more impressive to be honest, because of how annoying he could be. He could literally get rid of people's Vanish, and when the opponent switches, it's so many debuffs. And, you know, like, just, and, you know, like, him being annoying and also being able to hit hard at the same time, it feels so good to use him like that. So, I mean, not to say that Nova Shenron is crap or anything, but it's just Ice Shenron is more impressive in my opinion. Like, there's just something to Ice Shenron that, you know, he just feels more comfortable to use than Nova Shenron, because with Nova Shenron, you have to pop his main ability out at a time when you have no cards, because if you pop it, then you're literally using your own locking mechanism against you, because if you lock your, because his main ability destroys all of your cards and also locks yourself and your the opponent in for 10 timer counts. So that's a huge risk, because your opponent can actually use that against you, as proven in those matches. I got caught by it so many times, literally. Like, people can use the lock-in mechanism against you, and it's just going to result in a massive L. And plus, it just destroys all of your cards and theirs. So it literally depends on who gets the card first, and then they just go full force, and that can really screw your game up. So that's the only downside to using Minerva Shenron. It's just that, he compensates the wrong things for damage inflicted buffs. Like, I get that, okay, we get a vanishing gauge, we get damage inflicted, but I don't know if they should take it that far to lock us and the opponent in and also take our cards away just to get those buffs. I think that's a bit too far, but honestly, for what he is, 70% damage inflicted, loads of, like GT support buffs. He's not terrible, but overall, I think Ice Shenron's better. So I'm definitely going to put my Z power into him when I can. And then him on a GT team, honestly, it's not that terrible. But I feel like where these two can really shine is on powerful opponent, because there's just more scope to deal with on that team. Because like with GT, it's only just starting to get fleshed out, and GT is a team where you need Zenkais. Like, you need to run them with Zenkai Super Saiyan 4 Goku. You need Zenkai Super Saiyan 4 Vegeta, Super 17. I think you need them to back you up. So just running the Shadow Dragons and Super Saiyan 4 Vegeta doesn't really seem too good. It's not a bad team either, but it's not broken. So that's why, you know, running these guys on GT without the Zenkais, it's not good. It's really not good. So yeah, and plus I don't even have the GT Zenkais anyway because I don't really want a Zenkai them. I don't really want to run GT anyway because even though they're good, it's just not worth it it's just not worth it in my case. I'd rather just find ways to defeat them. So, you know, like, you know, found countless ways to defeat Super Saiyan 4 Goku. No, was it the Super Saiyan 4 Goku? Just bring a good yellow, honestly. Same thing with the Super Saiyan 4 Vegeta, just bring a good blue, honestly. It's just common sense. So I'd rather not waste my crystals on constructing a new team. I'd rather just focus on the teams that I have. So for GT, they're not bad, but Ice Shenron is truly the better one in my opinion. So next video we'll try them out a powerful opponent. I'm maybe thinking a blue-blue-yellow setup because since we have a yellow and a blue, we may as well bring another blue powerful opponent and then just make the bench yellow-yellow-blue and then buffers, and like, that'll be cool. So yeah, I'll definitely try that out. But yeah, that's it. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. Ice Shenron, definitely a madman. Nova Shenron. It just takes a bit of time for him to get built up, but he's just going to do amazing strike damage. So yeah, make sure you like the video, subscribe to the channel, and I'll see you lot in the next showcase. Peace out.